Enter his gates with thanksgiving in your hearts. Enter his courts with praise. Light up your lamps as you wait for his return, for he will come again. He will come again, he will come again. Jesus will come again. Light up your lamps as you wait for his return, for he will come again.
This Mass is offered for those running businesses. Wedding anniversary blessings for Savio and Athalia D'Souza, Russell and Gail Esperance. Thanksgiving to the Holy Family. Thanksgiving from James Mascarenhas and family. Thanksgiving for good health of Das family. Thanksgiving for the blessing of a baby girl. Birthday blessings for Christine Pinto, David Rodericks, Constance Amara. For the souls of Mr. and Mrs. William D'Souza and family. Baby Ria Dunbar, Edward Fernandez, Lucy Gonzalez, Gary, Paul, Anna and Joachim Fernandez, and Winnie and Michael Waller, Muriel and Andrew Rosario, Susan Oliveira, Hilda and William Falcon, Magdalene Burrows, Bella Elizabeth Fernandez, Souls in Purgatory, and Trevor Joseph Pereira. We also join those celebrating their birthdays and anniversaries and other happy occasions. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We join Mary in praising and thanking the Lord for the blessings he showers on us as we seek pardon and forgiveness for all our sins. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray, O God, who seeing the human race fallen into death, will to redeem it by the coming of your only begotten Son. Grant, we pray, that those who confess his incarnation with humble fervor may merit his company as their Redeemer, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. In those days, Hannah took Samuel up with her, along with a three-year-old bull, an ephah of flour, and a skin of wine, and she brought him to the house of the Lord at Shiloh. And the child was young. Then they slaughtered the bull, and they brought the child to Eli. And she said, O my Lord, as you lived, my Lord, I am the woman who was standing here in your presence, praying to the Lord. For this child I prayed, and the Lord has granted me my petition that I have made to him. Therefore, I have lent him to the Lord. As long as he lives, he is lent to the Lord. And he worshipped the Lord there. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The words of our response are, My heart exults in the Lord, my Savior. Kindly listen to the tune.
My heart exults in the Lord, my Savior.
All together.
My heart exults in the Lord, my Savior.
My heart exults in the Lord. My horn exalted in the Lord. My mouth derides my enemies because I rejoice in your salvation.
My heart exalts in the Lord, my Savior.
The bows of the mighty are broken, but the feeble bind on strength. Those who were full have hired themselves out for bread, but those who were hungry have ceased to hunger. The barren has borne seven, but she who has many children is forlorn.
My heart exalts in the Lord, my Savior. Alleluia, alleluia, King of David, come, unlock the gates of heaven. Alleluia,
all together.
Alleluia, alleluia, King of David, come, unlock the gates of heaven.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has looked on the humble estate of his servant. For behold, from now on, all generations will call me blessed. For he who is mighty has done great things for me. And holy is his name. And his mercy is from those who fear him, from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones and exalted those of humble estate. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, as he spoke to our fathers, to Abraham, and to his offspring forever." And Mary remained with her about 3 months and returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We find in our readings today two women. In the first place, we have Hannah, who is blessed with Samuel after many years. And then, of course, we have Mary singing the Magnificat, the prayer of praise, while she encounters her cousin Elizabeth, who had been barren for a long time and has been blessed with child. If you pay close attention to the prayer of the Magnificat, the beautiful hymn of praise, it has in it so many elements. The first place, it is remembering what the Lord has done out of his love and mercy, how he has helped the people of Israel. And at the same time, it is a very personal prayer from Our Lady, thanking God for having chosen her to be special and having given her so many gifts. Brothers and sisters, each and every day of our lives, we pray. What is our prayer really like? Is our prayer a complete demand from God for everything that we require? Or is it a prayer of surrender? Is it a prayer of praise and thanksgiving? Because we must always praise the Lord. Sometimes we take this relationship with God for granted. So as soon as we get up in the morning, or if we are praying before we go to sleep, or if we are praying during our free time, we must praise and thank the Lord. And while doing this, we must remember with gratitude everything that the Lord has done for us. Even if we are going through struggles and difficult moments, the Lord has not abandoned us. And this is what we should be grateful for. So during this season, which is slowly coming to an end, and as we look forward to the celebration of Christmas, let us always praise and thank the Lord for the gift of life, for the gift of our family, for the gift of our faith, for the gift of Jesus, and importantly, for the gift of the opportunity to be able to be his disciples in the world. Amen.
At the
last time of giving. Gladly now we bring gifts that have been given by our God and King. Here is our bread of faith, work of human hands. This is the bread of joy we will share in love at this time of giving. Gladly now we bring gifts that have been given by our God and King. See, Lord, this joy is wine harvested from us. This is our wine of love, ready for the feast.
Let us pray that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands in the praise and glory of his name for our good and good of all his holy church.
Trusting in your compassion, O Lord, we come eagerly with our offerings to your sacred altar, that through the purifying action of your grace we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice in the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exalted in his praise. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we proclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Oswald our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Our act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present.
I believe that you are present.
In the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things.
I love you above all things.
And I desire to receive you.
And I desire to receive you
into my soul.
Into my soul.
Since I cannot at this moment. Receive you sacramentally.
Receive you sacramentally.
Come at least spiritually into my heart.
Come at least spiritually into my heart.
I embrace you as if you were already there.
I embrace you as if you were already there.
And unite myself wholly to you.
I unite myself wholly to you.
Never permit me.
Never permit
to be separated from you.
To be separated from you.
Amen.
Amen.
Come, Lord Jesus. Come, Lord Jesus. Come, Lord Jesus. Come and be born in us. Come, Emmanuel.
For this life that you have given us, for the health we enjoy, for our families, our friends, our relatives, colleagues at work. We thank you and praise you for the many ways in which you have kept us safe from sin and from harm. Lord, we thank you for all that you give us out of your generosity and mercy. May we always be like you, sharing the best that we have with others. We surrender into your hands the many people who have asked us to pray for them, and all those at this moment who are vulnerable and seeking your help, your presence and your love. We lift up to you the many broken families, broken relationships, and we pray, Lord, that all those who are suffering may enjoy your spirit of healing and be strengthened by your love. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Great indeed are your works, O Lord, now and evermore. Great indeed are your works, O Lord, now and evermore. You lead us all by the hand to your heavenly kingdom. Then at the end of all time, you will come in glory. Great indeed are your works, O Lord, now and evermore. Great indeed are your works, O Lord, now and evermore.